It's winner takes all. And here's your host, Geoffrey Wheeler.
Hello, welcome once again to the programme. You know, Winner Takes All is a programme which makes people think, and it's funny the way that they think. They sometimes think that if a question has got short odds, it must be easy. If it's got long odds, it must be difficult. You know, they think if it's 2-1, then it's too easy. And if it's 10-1, they tend to wonder if they can get it. It's not actually so. Of course, the odds have nothing to do with the difficulty of the questions. What is important is the cleverness of the contestants. And that's something that always amazes me. So stand by to be amazed as we meet some more contestants in the care of our hostess, Vicky MacDonald. Vicky. Oh. Oh, my word. Lovely, Vicky. I can't wait for autumn. Yes, very nice indeed. Lovely. Tell us who we've got here.
On your left, we have Pam Darby from Coventry.
Hello, Pam. Hello.
And here we have Brian Daugherty from Newcastle.
Brian, lovely. Thank you, Vicky. Pam, now, your job has a long title. You are personal assistant to the Professor of Clinical Neurophysiology and Departmental Administrator at Aston University.
That's right, yes.
Now, what does he actually do? What sort of work is that?
He does research into the electrical activity of the brain.
Really?
And we also carry out a lot of research into the optometry.
Hmm. And what is optometry?
Optometry is ophthalmic optics. You go into a high street practitioner, have your eyes tested, and walk out with a pair of spectacles.
I see. Oh. And you're in charge of a team of 9 secretaries, I gather.
That's right, yes.
Lovely. But you're also something of an adventurous young lady because you parachute.
Yes, I've done a few jumps from 2,000 feet. I'll go to Hereford.
Weren't you frightened?
No, it's lovely, yes.
What does it feel like?
It's very quiet.
Hmm. As long as the parachute opens, it's nice.
That's right, yes.
Wonderful, Pam. Good to see you. Okay. And over here I've got Brian Daugherty from Newcastle. Well, you're from Liverpool originally, I think, Brian, aren't you? That's a Liverpool name, I'd say. And you're a maths student at Newcastle University. Well, you've gone from one side of the country to the other. How do you like the change?
Well, I've only just arrived in Newcastle, but it seems all right from what I've seen, obviously.
Seems all right. That's a very dumb. It's a lovely place, believe me. And your hobbies are astronomy. Are you in an astronomical society?
Yeah, I'm a member of a society in South Shields.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And you're interested in aircraft and railway preservation.
Yeah.
Have things got to be actually working to be valid as preserved?
Well, most railway societies actually get them in working order. But as far as aircraft go, I mean, it's mostly just static displays.
Yes.
One or two working aircraft, but that's all.
Yes, lovely. Well, fascinating hobby, and I hope you're going to be fascinated by the contest. Are you ready, Pam? You ready,
yeah.
Brian? Lovely. Now, this is a real contest. There's no oncoming champion this time, so you're really in it to get into the final. OK, here we go. First question. What is grown in a paddy field? Is it grass, moss, chamomile, rice, or four-leafed clover? How much do you want to go? You can stake up to 30 points, Brian.
Yeah, I'll go 30.
You'll go 30? What about you, Pam?
30 points.
30, please. Right home. Make your bets. And you've both gone for the 5-1 rice. And, of course, you're right, as this picture shows. Well done. Next question. What is the everyday name for the St. Paulia? Is it primula, African violet, pelargonium, cyclamen, or begonia? How much are you going to go, Brian?
I'll just go 15, I think.
15, right, you're not so sure. What about you, Pam?
I'll go 15 as well, please.
Right, you've each got 100... you're doing very well so far. You've each got 165 now, so press your button. Make a choice. Well, Brian says it's the African violet, Pam says it's the pelargonium, and Brian is right, it is the African violet, and here it is. Just have a look at this. Films, are you good at films?
No.
Are you good at films?
No.
There should be a riot then. Which musical film was based on the story of the rape of the Sabine women? Was it West Side Story, Kiss Me Kate, Seven Brides for Seven Brothers, Fiddler on the Roof, or The Boys from Syracuse? Right, now, how much would you like to go, Brian?
I'll go 30.
You go 30 again. What about you, Pam?
20, please.
20, right, yes. Ho, press your buttons. Let me know which you think was the one. And again, a difference of opinion. Brian thinks it's Seven Brides, and you think it's Fiddler on the Roof. It was Seven Brides for Seven Brothers. And this was the poster that used to entice people into the cinema in those days. Seven Brides for Seven Brothers. On to the next question. Are you good at identifying voices, Pam?
No.
Well, you are, Brian, aren't you?
Not really, no.
Well, I think you might get this one. Tell me, both of you, whose voice is this?
How pleasant to know Mr. Lear, who has written such volumes of stuff. Some think him ill-tempered and queer, but a few think him pleasant enough. His mind is concrete and fastidious. His nose is remarkably big. His visage is more or less hideous. His beard, it resembles a wig.
How pleasant to know Mr. Lear. Now, whose voice was that? Was it John Gielgud, Anthony Quinn, Garfield Morgan, Peter Bowles, or Michael Horden? How many will you go, Brian?
I'll go 30, please.
What about you, Pam?
I'll go 30 points.
Righto, you get 30 points, and press your buttons. And you both think it was Sir John Gielgud, and of course you were right. And here he is. ...205 to 405, and we're on to the last question. Take a look at this picture. In which city can you see this throne? Is it Tehran, Istanbul, Delhi, Marrakesh, or Cairo? And let me remind you of your choice. In which city can you see that throne? Is it Tehran, Istanbul, Delhi, Marrakesh, or Cairo? For the last time, how many do you want to go, Brian?
Well, might as well go 30.
Yeah, I think you might as well, honestly. What about you, Pam?
Go 30, please.
You'll go 30. Okay. Press your buttons. And a difference of opinion. Pam thinks it's Delhi. Brian thinks it's Istanbul. It was in the Topkapi Palace in Istanbul. So, 175 points you have, Pam, but that doesn't get you into the final, I'm afraid.
Never mind.
You go back to Aston University. I imagine that there's all sorts of things you could find out in the library there, but just to top up your own personal supply of knowledge, we're giving you our encyclopedia, which I hope you'll enjoy reading and remembering your visit to us here. Have you enjoyed it?
I've really enjoyed it, thank you.
Good, lovely. Nice to have you with us, Pam.
Thank you.
£495, Brian. That's very good. That gets you into the final. And, you know, if you turn that into money, you could be the winner in the final. We shan't know until we get to the final. And who you'll be meeting there, we shall find out in a moment when we meet the next two people who are going to play Winner Takes All. Vicky, tell us all about it.
Well, here we have John Wilson from Liverpool.
Hello, John.
And on your right, we have Joyce Spanner from London.
Hello, Joyce. Thank you, Vicky. John Wilson from Liverpool, and you are a higher executive officer, the Home Office Computer Division, Bootle. What does that mean you do?
It sounds a lot grander than it really is.
It sounds very grand.
Well, I'm bound by the Official Secrets Act, but what I do is...
Oh, all right, then. Well, let's talk about football.
York and St. Helens Rugby League, yes.
Yes.
I support York when I'm home in York, which is where I come from, and St Helens when I'm exiled the other side of the Pennines in Liverpool.
Well, splendid. You also get involved in quizzes, I believe.
That's right, I'm playing four nights a week at present. I'm
four
on
nights
overkill.
A week?
Four nights a week, yes.
Good grief. Well, you should be good, shouldn't you?
I don't know, I think I'm probably been total overkill.
You've peaked too soon.
I've peaked too soon, it's all
you're
gone.
You're burnt out, John.
That's right.
Yes, you're but a hulk of what you
Absolutely.
Used to be. Rubbish. Come across here and say hello to Joyce. Now, Joyce, you're an assistant manager with the National Westminster Bank.
That's right, yes.
Are you a bit of a leader in this field? Because it's quite new for women to become managers and assistant managers, isn't it?
I don't think there are as many women managers in the bank as I'd like to see. But we're getting there. It's taking us a while, but we're getting there.
I'm sure you are. And you were a sergeant in the Territorial Army.
I was, yes.
Did you enjoy that?
Very much, yes. All the square bashing and the polishing boots and...
Oh, my goodness me.
Walking about in the mud and everything. I loved it, yes.
Did you really? Well, I hope you're going to love playing Winner Takes All. So, are you ready? Here we go with your first question. In which sport did the phrase to lead with the chin originate? Was it horse racing, boxing, fencing, bobsleigh, or archery? How many would you like to go, Joyce? You can stake up to 30 points, you know.
I'd like to go 10 on that, Geoffrey.
10 on that?
Yes.
Right-ho. What about you, John?
30, please.
30. Press your buttons. And you both agree on the 3-1 boxing. You're both right. Well done. The next question is a viewer's question, and I'm very grateful to Jack Wilkinson of Hebburn, near Newcastle-on-Tyne, for sending us this question. Thanks very much indeed, Mr. Wilson, for your question. Hope you're going to enjoy hearing it on the air. You may be successful in defeating our contestants. Either way, you'll be getting a winner-takes-all pen through the post as a souvenir. Here's your question. What is a Staffordshire Blue? Is it a brick, a butterfly, a postage stamp, a breed of dog, or a flower? So, how many would you like to go, John, on this one?
I'll go 20 on this, please.
You'll go 20. What about you, Joyce?
I'll go 20.
You'll go 20. Right, press your buttons. And a difference of opinion. John thinks that it's a brick, and Joyce thinks it's a butterfly. In fact, John is right. It is a brick. It is a brick. And this is what a Staffordshire Blue looks like. It has that sort of blue tinge in it. On to the third question, and the scores, 40 to Joyce and 160 to John. Tell me, who use hatching and cross-hatching in their work? Is it etchers, thatchers, ditchers, poachers, or rat catchers? How many are you going to go on this one, John?
I'll go 30, please.
You'll go 30? Why not? What about you,
30.
Joyce? You'll go 30?
30, yes.
Fine, right-ho. Press your buttons. And you're both agreed that it is etchers. And you are both right. Well done. Just to show you what it looks like, take a look at this picture. This is an etching. But if you go very close to it and look at the detail of the face, round about the chin there, you'll see that that is done with what's called cross-hatching, lines going one way and then other lines going across them. Cross-hatching. So, on to the fourth question, and I want you to look at a picture and listen to some music. And tell me, who wrote Every Time We Say Goodbye, sung here by Mick Hucknall of Simply Red?
Every time we say goodbye, I die a little. Every time.
Who wrote Every Time We Say Goodbye, which was sung there by Mick Hucknall of Simply Red? Was it George Gershwin, Irving Berlin, Lorenz Hart, Cole Porter, or Jerome Kern? How many would you like to go on this one, John?
Great voice. I think I'll go 30, please.
It's a great voice, and I think you're wise. Joyce?
I'll go 20.
You go 20, right here. Press your buttons. Right. John thinks it's Cole Porter. Joyce thinks it's Jerome Kern. It was Cole Porter. And if you just take a look at the sheet music, you'll see there is his portrait, Cole Porter. So, on to the final question with the scores 370 to 80. Where is the valley of 10,000 smokes? Is it in Iceland, on the North Island of New Zealand, the South Island of New Zealand, Alaska, or in a Turkish hammam? Right, how much do you want to go, John?
30, please.
30? What about you, Joyce?
I'll go 30.
You'll go 30. Press your buttons for the last time. And Joyce thinks it's the South Island of New Zealand, John thinks it's Alaska, and John is right. It is Alaska. And this is what the Valley of the 10,000 Smokes looks like. There it is, with the smoke coming out of the holes in the ground. Well, that's the end of the contest, I'm afraid. And Joyce, you're going to have to leave us. But it's been very good having you with us. Have you enjoyed being with us?
Very much, yes.
Good. Well, back to London. You'll be taking the encyclopedia as a souvenir of your visit. And, of course, our good wishes. Joyce. But John, you of course are in the final and you will be meeting that math student from Newcastle University, Brian Daugherty. That should be quite a contest and we look forward to seeing that in just a few moments' time. I hope you'll be joining us too. Don't go away. Well done, John.
Get the maximum coffee taste.
Get the max.
Get the maximum rich and smooth.
Get the max.
Get the maximum blend. Get the max with a friend.
Maxwell House is the way to the taste of today.
Get the maximum smooth, rich roast.
Get the max.
Get the coffee that captures most.
Get the max.
When you taste, there's no doubt you get full flavor out.
Get the maximum taste. That's what it's all about. Get the max.
Get the taste. Get the max.
You know how much fun a cheap day return can be? Well, how about a ticket that's just the same, but also lets you stay away for up to a month? A safer return turns a journey into a joyride.
This is the new star, a bigger star, a better star.
With lively and more informative stories daily, a comprehensive four-page TV pullout daily, play Snakes and Ladders, a brand new game. Use your daily number on a real board to win instant and weekly prizes and win 20,000 air tickets worth over £2 million to use on a two-week bonus holiday.
The star has changed. Get your new star tomorrow and keep light years ahead.
If tartar built up on the prongs of a fork, you'd never allow it in your mouth. But you let tartar build up on your teeth. Harmful bacteria can breed there, and your dentist scrapes it away because ordinary toothpaste can't do much about it. But with new Tartar Control Crest, almost everyone has less tartar, and some have none at all. So get help from new Tartar Control Crest. All you want in your mouth are healthy teeth, and tartar-free teeth are healthier.
Your game. Oh, you're
shattered.
Hello, welcome to the final of Winner Takes All, where it's all for real money. With me I have John Wilson of Liverpool, who is coming forward to the final for the first time, as they, indeed they both are. And you are a member of the Campaign for Real Ale.
That's right, yes.
And how deeply do you feel about this, John?
Well, I never touch lager.
Ah.
When I go out for a drink, I like to enjoy myself. And I feel that some of the keg beer that was prevalent in the 1960s and 70s was virtually undrinkable, and I think it's of great credit to Camra to show that the work has been done in the increased availability and production of real ale in the past 15 years.
It's good stuff, isn't it? From the wood. It's
from
lovely. Now, I know that, I normally say, right, come out, shake hands now and come out of your corners fighting, but I know that you and Brian have been talking before the contest, and you find you have something in common. He's a math student at Newcastle University, and you were there too.
Yes, I did German there about 10 years ago, yes.
And the coincidence is even greater than that.
The coincidence is even more. I used to live in flat 19E, which is two floors above the flat in which Brian is living now.
Yes. Oh, extraordinary. Well, there you are. Well, anyway, put aside all thoughts of friendship. It's fighting to the death now as we come to the final. And Brian, you're studying maths, of course, and are you settling into Newcastle?
Yeah.
You're very cool, aren't you? You're from Liverpool, aren't you?
Yeah.
Well, according to John, Newcastle was a fantastic place. He had a really good time. Have you got to know the people there at all?
Well, to a certain extent. I mean, you're a bit insulated in the university, aren't you, from the real people, I suppose. But
well, I suppose you are. But do try and get out and about and get to know the city, because it's a terrific... And you really can have a wonderful time there. Anyway, we're going to have a wonderful time in the final of the contest now. Are you both ready? Here we go, then. The first question. What would you find at the 19th hole? Would it be the tee, the clubhouse, the fairway, a water hazard, or a bunker? You've got £30, Ryan. How many do you want to go?
30.
You'll go 30. What about you, John?
30, please.
Good. Make your bets. And you both think you'd find the clubhouse, you'd both be right. I want you to listen to some music and tell me who wrote this Easter hymn from Cavalleria Rusticana. Easter hymn from Cavalleria Rusticana. Was it Rossini, Mascagni, Bellini, Donizetti, or Berlioz? How many are you going to go, Brian?
Well, I'll try 20, I suppose.
You'll try £20, you suppose, right? What about you, John?
I'll go 30, please.
You'll go 30. You're a bit more confident. Press your buttons. And John thinks it's Mascagni, Brian thinks it's Bellini. In fact, it is Mascagni. And here is Mascagni. There's the man himself. Wondering whether he's done a good job. I think he did very well. It's a lovely piece of music. Now take a look at this picture and tell me in which city, in which capital city, is this art centre? Is it Stockholm, London, Paris, New York or Berlin? You've had a good look at it. Let me remind you of your choice. In which capital city was that art centre? Was it Stockholm, London, Paris, New York or Berlin? Now, you've got £210, John. How many would you like to go?
I'll go 30, please.
You've got 30. You've got £100, Brian.
Yeah, I'll go 30 as well.
You'll go 30, right-ho. And Brian thinks it's London. John thinks it's Paris. In fact, it is London because it's the Barbican. So, this is very exciting. John, £180. Brian just in the lead with £190. Neck and neck, and the lead keeps changing. Here we go. Take a look now at a piece of film. Which country was ruled by this man for 21 years? Was it Turkey, Romania, Albania, Yugoslavia, or Italy? So, which country was ruled by that man for 21 years? Was it Turkey, Romania, Albania, Yugoslavia, or Italy? And you're just in the lead, Brian, so you have the privilege.
Well, 30.
You'll go 30. What about you, John?
30, please.
You'll go 30. Press your buttons. And you're agreed it's Italy, and since it was Mussolini, of course, you're right. £490, Brian, with £480 from John, right on your tail. It gets quite tense, doesn't it, John?
It does.
Yes, you sometimes wish question masters would get on with the questions and stop winding you up. All right, I will. The last question, then. Here we go. Which chemical element is always present in any alloy called amalgam? Is it aluminium, mercury, platinum, zinc, or silver? For the last time, Brian, how many are you going to go?
30.
I think you may as well go 30. John?
30.
30, right. Press your buttons. And you're both agreed it is mercury. You are both right. John, that is an incredible... incredibly close match, isn't it? £570. You did very well indeed. That is a terrific total. It's one of the highest totals we've had, but it's not enough to beat our champion.
I thought
champion,
it was the Centre Pompidou in Paris, as simple as that.
Is that what you thought, yes, Dan? Yes, you thought yes, it was the Pompidou? Yes. Well, it did look a bit like it. Anyway, it's been grand having you on the programme, and you're going to go back to Liverpool, in fact, to Bootle, to work the computer there.
Yes.
It's been grand having you with
Thanks
us.
Very much.
John. Brian, that very cool customer from Newcastle University, originally from Liverpool, who's got £580. Brian, come down and join me. Well done. Terrific. Very good. Well, Brian, you've got £580. You can take that back to Newcastle and, as I suggest, go out on the town and enjoy it. Or you can come back again and build it up even more. Of course, if you come back and you lose, you'll only get half of it. What are you going to do?
Well, I might as well come back for the next programme.
You're going to come back. That's splendid. Well done. John, come and join us. Well done. Well, that's the end of this programme. In the next one, John won't be with us, but, of course, Brian will be as laid back and calm as ever. Vicky will be here. I'll be here. I hope you will, too. Join us once again for Winner Takes All. Goodbye now.